So put your hands together for one of the baddest white boys in the country. This motherfucker's funny for Gay Owen!
I ain't got two. I just got the one ham. Beak, beak, beak. Fuck up. Two. Just got the one. And so I'll be at nightclubs with one on. Bang, bang, bang. Good to be here in L.A., man. L.A. A lot of celebrities in the audience. I saw Morse Chestnut here. Yeah. Man, am I the only one? Every time I see Boys in the Hood, I think Ricky Might Live for some reason. Like when he's running in the alley, he think he might make a left or something. You be pulling for Morris. Don't go to the store! You passed the test! The Bloods are coming in a tiny car, Morris! They're gonna kill you! You be pulling, man. Stop feeding the fucking Twinkies, bro. Pay attention. Die every time. It's just Doughboy. Fuck.
It was good. It was good in that movie.
I'm glad, you know what I'm glad about last couple weeks? I'm glad Tiger's just back to playing golf, you know? God. Man. I mean, you know, I hear every politician, I hear every comedian talk about Tiger. I'm like, I don't know what, you know, I don't blame him for nothing. I blame his wife for everything. I don't blame Tiger for shit, you know? You know, ladies, listen to me. If you're married to a billionaire, don't check his phone. Leave him alone. He's a billionaire, okay? You don't check a billionaire's phone, okay? Now, if you're married to a man that makes $50,000 a year, check his shit, you know? Because you can find another man that makes $50,000 a year. You ain't gonna find another billionaire. Doesn't Tiger's wife know she peaked? She got nowhere to go but down after Tiger. Let me tell you something. If my wife's a billionaire, I'm not checking shit. She can do whatever she wants. I'm not fucking up my lifestyle because she wants a little dick on the side. She deserves that dick. She's a billionaire. You earned that dick, baby. That's your dick. You enjoy that dick. That is your dick. All right? Now, whatever you're doing him ain't got shit to do with us. We good. Yeah, it's your dick, baby. You enjoy that dick. That is your dick. Check a billionaire's phone? How y'all ain't got one phone, Tiger? One phone? Just one goddamn phone. One. Just one. Goddamn, I'm a billionaire. I got 365 prepaids, goddamn it. What's going on? A lot of pretty girls in L.A. A lot of pretty, beautiful. I mean, L.A. got some pretty girls, man. Got some ugly motherfuckers, too, though. Wow, shit! That's the one thing I don't understand about women. Why don't ugly women know they're ugly? That shit bothers me, ladies. How do you not know you ugly, you know? Pretty women know they're pretty. Why don't ugly women know they're ugly, you know? And if y'all ugly, ladies, it's cool. I don't blame you. I blame your parents. It's genetics, you know? Because I hate that shit when people say, well, two ugly people can make a pretty baby. Well, that pretty baby's gonna be an ugly-ass adult when she grows up and her parents' features kick in. Two ugly people ain't making no pretty adult. Suck my dick. That doesn't happen. You can make a pretty baby. Babies ain't got bones yet. Once that bone structure kicks in, it's a wrap. Make a pretty adult, ugly people. Impress me. Make a pretty adult. Anybody make a pretty baby. That shit ain't hard. I can't even talk to you. I'm married, man. I'm married now, too, man. I'm married for 7 years, man. 7 years, man. Goddamn, you know. My beautiful, man. Beautiful woman, man. She's beautiful. Man, a lot of people know I'm married to a black lady. You know, black lady from Oakland. You know, it's my... Yeah. Woo! Man! I ain't even know. Woo! Got our kids, man. The kids fucking... And you know, it's funny, man. When you're a white dude and you marry a black woman, people always assume shit. You know, from the outside looking in, they assume the white guy's probably better off and a better background, you know? It's just the opposite, you know? Like, my wife went to UC Santa Barbara. All her cousins and uncles went to UCLA and Stanford. I'm from a trailer park in Ohio, you know? I had one cousin go to DeVry. We think he's a fucking genius, you know?
You'd be like, damn, Jerry, how'd you do that shit? I was just watching TV and my life changed. You the one, Jerry. You the one, baby. The ride, class of February. Supposed to graduate in April.
Got our kids, man. You got the kids, man. You know what I mean? Mixed kids, man. You know, mixed kids. You don't know what you're getting with the mixed kids, man. You know, especially with the hair. The hair, you know, I think two white people get together, you pretty much know. Two black people, you pretty much know. Mixed, you don't know. You know, because, man, because my son's older. You know, my son, man, he's got great hair. Long and curly, you know. Run your fingers through it, it bounces right back. Ding! Wing! My daughter, man! That's some nappy shit, man. I can't comb her hair. I can't get her ready for school. Dad! Oh, my God! Blame your mom. This ain't my fault, yeah. I'm gonna get you ready for school. Squirt, squirt. There you go, son. Have a good day. Thanks, Dad. No, thank you, son. Thank you. My son's, he's nine, he's playing basketball now, right? Only black kid on the team, right? All the kids are white, man. He's fucking dominating, you know? Like, I like to take the credit, but I think his mom had a little bit to do with it, you know? But like, all the other kids, like, most of the kids in his league are white kids. There's not a lot of black kids in the league. So every time I go to a game, I go sit with the other parents, you know? Because they don't know the black kids' minds. So all the other white parents, I'll be hyping them up, too. They be sitting there, that black kid's pretty good. That motherfucker's sweet! We can't stop him! Oh, this is funny. Kids got baptized too last year. They got baptized, man. Woo! Man. Got baptized black. Man, that's the one thing I didn't know. I got baptized at a black church, and that, you know. God! Why does it take so long? Black church takes forever! I grew up going to white church, man, you know? Service starts at 10, 10:30, we're at IHOP, already enjoying our breakfast. Matter of fact, I went to black church, I didn't know, you know? I was just sitting there, you know? And I was like, why is it taking so long? And then I finally realized, having this service, why it's taking so long, because when you go to church with white people, man, we don't say nothing, you know? When the preacher's talking, we shut up and we listen, you know? If somebody tries to talk when the preacher's talking, we tell them, shh, zip it, focus, okay? Two more songs, we're out of here. Shh. See, I didn't know when you go to a black church, I didn't know that when black people agree with what the preacher's talking about, don't wait. They yelled out right there, they agree. I didn't know, you know? So I was getting upset with the other people in the pews because I thought they were being disrespectful, you know? Because I was just sitting there, preach on it! Are you serious? You're just going to talk while he's talking? Why don't you zip in focus, man? It's 1:30, I'm ready to go home! About it. Are you with him? What? You're allowed to talk? Are you serious? I'm gonna say something. Okay, watch. I'm gonna say something. Hoodie hoo! I hoodie hoo for Jesus, but come on, it's 3:00. I wanna go home. Another song? Why is she singing Alicia Keys? It has nothing to do with Jesus. You guys have a step team? Are you serious? The First Baptist Steppers? It's 6:00. I want to go. I'm starving. I need breakfast. A poet? You have a poet. This is a freaking talent show. I True story.
Oh my God.
I always tell white people when I'm at my shows, but look, if you've never been to a black church, you gotta go just one time. I mean, don't make no plans.
You ain't gonna catch the game. You ain't gonna catch the game, you know?
But I always tell white people, I said, look, if you decide to go to a black church and you've never been, if somebody gives you a hard time for being there, just say Jesus, you know? Because nobody messes with Jesus, you know? Like, hey, man, what are you doing here? Jesus. Who you know in here? Jesus. How'd you get here? Jesus brought me. And if Jesus don't work, just say Sister Johnson. Every black church has at least one Sister Johnson, okay? You're gonna have a friend in there somewhere. Hey man, what are you doing here, Sister Johnson? Who you know in here, Sister Johnson? How you know Sister Johnson? Jesus. We met at IHOP. 10:45. I was there last week. My wife, you know, I was talking about my wife earlier. I got sidetracked though, but you know, I remember we was in bed one night. I was with my wife one night. We were talking, man, and you know, you start talking about your past, and she told me, she's like, I'm just letting you know, you're the only white guy I've ever been with. And at first I was like, yes. And then I went, ah, shit. That means some brothers was in this shit before me, you know? So that's why I never asked my wife, is this the biggest dick you ever have? Mm-mm. I'm not trying to hurt my feelings.
I say other shit, is this the most aggressive dick? Is this the feistiest dick?
It's the most aggressive!
Yeah, got that aggressive dick.
It's funny too, man, because lately I've been noticing lately, man, you gotta be careful what you say everywhere because people get in trouble. I saw, you know, with the YouTube and the hidden cameras, you know, I saw Dog the Bounty Hunter and Michael Richards and now John Mayer, you know, come and get caught saying the N-word, man, you know, and I, you know, N-word, you know, I don't know. You know, I don't say it, you know, in public.
I don't.
I'm not gonna sit here and be one of these white guys like I've never said it. I've said this shit from time to time when I'm by myself and the door's locked, you know? You know I don't like the N-word personally. Why I don't like it is because my kids can say it freely and I can't. That shit bothers me a little bit, you know? Like my son will punk me in my own house. Say it, Dad, I dare you, say it. I bet you don't say it, and I'll tell all my uncles.
Fuck. Oh, you got me.
It messes you up, too, when you got black people in your family, you know? Because, you know, we'll be at the house playing cards and stuff, you know? And it fucks me up when black people call me the N-word out of affection. Because I'm like, how am I supposed to respond, you know? Like, I think sometimes black people be fucking with me and think I might say it back and they can bust me in my ass or something, you know? And we'll be at the house playing cards and never fails drinking. You know, Gary, just to let you know, man, you my what?
Likewise, motherfucker, likewise. Shit. I ain't that drunk. In fact, give me some coffee, baby. I almost slipped up. You almost got me, Teddy. You almost got me. Two cards, please.
LA got the actors, actresses, and the porn industry's out here, too. I didn't realize what a big industry that was, you know. I was just, you know, man, you know. I'll tell you what I was watching one night, man. I was in my hotel about 3 in the morning, and I'm watching Oprah. And Oprah's on there, and she's got this girl on there, you know, and her name is Corinne Steffens, and her nickname is Superhead, you know. And I'm watching this, right? And I'm looking at it, and I'm like, what are they talking about, you know? And I didn't know that this girl, she gives, like, the best blowjobs in the whole world, I guess, you know, because nickname's Superhead, you know. She actually wrote a book about it. It's called Confessions of a Video Vixen. And I'm watching, I'm looking at it, you know, and I'm like, so I went and bought the book because Oprah said buy it, you know, and I thought it'd be a good read, you know. So, because she was on Oprah, and I guess when I'm reading the book, she said it was about a 5-year run where she was in every major rap video because she was getting all the rappers' blowjobs, you know. So I bought the book, and I started reading it. She didn't just say I gave rappers blowjobs. No, she put names and dates. And I was like, what a bitch, man. These rappers got families, you know? And then I saw this tape. She actually released a tape of her giving this guy a blowjob. When I saw the tape, I was like, shit!
I gotta learn how to rap. Fuck comedy. God damn, are you serious? I ain't never seen a blowjob like this. I swear to God, every girl should see this tape. It'll save your relationship, ladies. It will, man. If you haven't seen this tape, it's called Honey versus Mr. Marcus, right? And Corinne plays Honey. And Mr. Marcus, this brother's a porno legend. He's a beast. Big swole brother, always got his hat on backwards and his socks on. Lazy as shit, though, man. Take the socks off, man. Respect the lady, you know? But usually, I've seen a couple of Mr. Marcus's videos, right? Like, usually he'll whip out his shit, and like an average girl gets scared of it, because it's pretty big, you know? And he'll put it towards a girl's face, and like a normal girl be like, oh my God, Mr. Marcus! I can't handle all that! Now, Superhead, Mr. Marcus whipped it out, put it right in her face! And she just stared at it! It was like a face-off before a heavyweight title fight. Just, And I'm watching, I'm like, what's she about to do with it? I ain't never seen no shit like this. She didn't start sucking it initially. No, she went away from the dick, you know? Like a snake, like an anaconda. Like she cocked her whole body and went away from it. She was just, dick's right here, sick, sick, sick. And then she spit on it. She spit on Mr. Marcus's dick. I swear to God, I have seen this tape about 1,000 times, right? I have yet to see the spit come out of her mouth. That just shot across the room out of nowhere. Pig spits on the dick. Tech spits on a dick. Tech spits on a dick. Now spits on a dick finally, right? Then she finally starts sucking it. Oh my God. And as she was sucking it, she put both hands on it and started moving her hands in a counterclockwise motion like this. It looked like the bitch was grinding pepper. I was like, fuck a blowjob. I want to go to grind some pepper, goddammit. I swear to God, I saw this tape. I can't go to Olive Garden anymore. I can't, man. Hi, would you like fresh ground pepper on your salad? Would I? That's what you gotta do, ladies. You gotta grind the pepper, okay? Hey, if his dick ain't that big, adjust the telescope. Adjust the telescope. Bring that little dick into focus. I'm Gary Owen, you guys. I appreciate it.